Hello and welcome to my tearing saga, Heroes of Ituna, Minimum Recruitment, Low Turn Count Playthrough, Chapter 1. The goal of this LTC is to get the lowest total turn count, including skirmishes, while recruiting as few units as possible. For the context of this game, I will count a unit as recruit if said unit appears in the result screen after the final chapter. This is an important point to mention, because there are several units in this game who can defect from your army permanently, and in this run, I will make sure that they do. Also, there are a few recruitable characters in this game who appear in the chapter as green units, and are automatically recruited at the end of it if they are still alive. I choose to recruit these units as I have almost no control over their survival, and waiting for the enemy units to kill them fast will be at best very unreliable and at worst almost impossible depending on the character. This LTC is intended to be humanly possible and without the use of safe states, so don't expect anything crazy like what I did in my Tour Assisted speedrun or displayed LTC run of this game. Now for the reason why I am doing this run. In most Fire Emblem games, doing a minimum recruitment LTC would have a very limited impact compared to a standard LTC due to most of the useful units being mandatory. However, for this game in particular, the most important units for an LTC are not mandatory, and it will lead to a totally different approach of the game, especially for its second half. Back to Chapter 1, the goal is to kill all the enemies, and we start with 4 characters. Troyan is our lord for now, and is pretty mediocre. This is due to his low base stat, and the fact that most of the chapters involving him are 6 objectives, meaning that he will not see a lot of combat. He will have to personally kill one enemy at one point in the game, so I will try to give him some experience points when I can. Troyan visits an house at the start of this chapter to learn Seafarer, which grants him +1 extra movement on C maps and will be relevant at a later chapter. Arkis and Kryce are the 2 Christmas Cavaliers of the games, and they are relatively bad compared to other mount units I will get later on, some of them as soon as the next chapter. Despite that, getting Kryce 8 levels to promote will be one of my long term goals, so you can expect to often see him trying to do cheap damage to enemies. For those wondering, here I took to Sasha to recruit her and Kate, otherwise they will be automatically recruited at the end of the chapter. Finally, there is Garou the Pirate. While his combat is good for now, he is held back by his slow 4 movement and his inability to increase it. I will use him a lot for an unrelated reason I will explain at a later video. Now about the 2 new recruits. Sasha is a princess, with 4 movement, who can promote early on into Pegasus Knight, and will be one of my top training priority, but she can't do much in this chapter. On the other hand, Kate is also a 4 movement unit, but unlike Sasha, she doesn't have anything special that would justify training her. It's important that the boss ends this turn in range of Garou and Kate, as they are the ones who will kill him, while my other units will finish anyone else still alive. Also, since I didn't have time to talk about it yet, among the items I got from the town, there is an iron sword with an innate +1 critical rate. This sword will get an additional +1 critical each time I kill an enemy with it, and I will increase this critical as much as possible for reliability reasons. That's all I have to say about this chapter 1, complete in 6 turns. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.
Thank you.